Hi guys, so today I want to share another story with you. Today I want to talk about Dorit and PK Kemsley caught hiding money from judge in lawsuit case as financial problems worsen. Okay guys, I hate to do it to you again. I hate to bring you another Dorit's broke story, but I promise you guys I'm going to follow this story, and it's getting worse, people. It really is. I mean, and I just did a video 2 days ago on her bestie Kyle, who has her own lawsuit problems with her husband Mauricio, and I started that video by saying I'm really shocked to be doing this video about Mauricio because I really thought it would be PK. Well, to my surprise, 2 days later, it's PK. So let's get into what he's doing now. So now we're talking about the Nikos Kyrgios case. I cannot say that man's last name. I'm sorry. Kyrgios. We're talking about that case. Remember, PK had a friend that loaned him $1.2 million. I mean, I wouldn't even dare ask anybody for that much money. I wish I had friends like that. Like, hey, Kelly, can I borrow a cool $2 million? I mean, that's insane, people. But anyway, he gave them the money, and PK never paid him back. And so he took him to court, and now the judge has frozen one bank account, which had $30,000 in it. And the judge gave that money to Nikos, and they claimed they didn't have any more money. Well, I mean, they lied, people. They lied. Okay, so now Nikos has found out that they have another account, and this account is in Dorit's name, but PK deposits money into this account to avoid paying his judgments. I mean, that's really crazy. I'm thinking they should change the name from the Real Housewives of Beverly Hills to the Real Scammers of Beverly Hills. I mean, this is insane. He's doing any and everything to avoid paying his bills, people. That's what it boils down to. So basically, what he's saying in his deposition is, the evidence here is that Mr. Kemsley had his income deposited into Mrs. Kemsley's account. Mr. and Mrs. Kemsley have made no effort to rebut the presumption that the assets in the account are attributable to that deposit and have presented no evidence to trace the funds in the account to conclusively prove that they are attributable only to Mrs. Kemsley's separate income. And what that means is, they have no proof to verify that this is just Dorit's money. So Nikos is asking the judge to look into this new account, and if it's true, to freeze those funds too and then have those turned over to him. And I'm sure they're probably investigating if there's more accounts. I mean, that's just on me. That's just what I think. I mean, these two really are slipping on their scammer game because their plan really was dumb. That's like me having $1 million mysteriously shows up in my bank account. When the judge asked me, where does this money come from? I say, I don't know. But you're spending it every day. Yeah, I'm spending it, but I don't know where it comes from. I mean, please. It has to come from PK. What did they expect the judge to believe? Or did they think they would never get caught? I mean, PK and Dorit are really trying any and everything to prevent from paying this man the money that they rightfully owe him. And they're trying to avoid it because they really are going broke. They just don't have this bill to pay back that they're trying to lie their way out of. And you know what? Eventually, PK, you've got to stop the lie. You can't keep lying to judges. I mean, it will backfire on you. Duh. I mean, just in case you didn't know that, I think I should inform you. But they just don't have that bill. So they have the $1.2 million that they are trying to get out of paying Nikos, but they still owe him. Then they have $1 million tax lien that they owe. And then they have, it was one more bill, what was it? Oh, the Ryan Horn case. Remember, Dorit went into business starting her bathing suit company and he said that they didn't pay him? Of course, they're in mediation now, but you still have to pay that money back, okay? Just because it's in mediation and it's not in the public, eventually you have to pay the money back. And so what they're doing is robbing Peter to pay Paul. They're study juggling. But they don't have the money. If the money's not there, it's just not there. And let's be honest, people. I really like Boy George. I mean, he's a genius when it comes to singing. But if I asked my 16-year-old son right now who Boy George is, he would look at me like I was crazy. I mean, you're not making that much money off of Boy George anymore. I mean, no offense. I still like him, and it's not disrespectful to Boy George. But, you know, you have a certain amount of shelf life in the music industry, and you know, Boy George's time has come and passed, so he's really not making a lot of money here, people. So in the meantime, while these two are going broke, they go back to the cameras of the Real Housewives of Beverly Hills and pretend like they're rich. I mean, I don't understand, why are we pretending here? I mean, her accent is fake. Everything is fake. We know you're broke, but then you run around in designer clothes. It really doesn't make sense. Dorit is pretending like she's rich. Why is she still here? She is not rich, okay? But she's renting everything, pretending like everything is okay when it's really not. And it probably would be more acceptable to the public if she just came out and said, we're broke. You know, we have to reinvent ourselves. Like Toya did on Married to Medicine. You have to tell the truth, people. You really do. Because if you don't, it really makes you look bad. And I don't want anyone to think for one second that just because a person is rich, that they are incapable of going broke. No, there's only one way to go broke, and that's if you live beyond your means. And I don't care if you make $15 an hour, you gotta live within that budget. Or if you make $100,000 an hour, you still have to have budgets, okay? No one can just spend willingly, because if you do, you'll end up broke like they have. So there you have it, people. That's my update on Dorit and PK's latest lawsuit. So what I want to know today in my comments section is, who believes that Dorit and PK truly are broke? Or do you think they're not paying back their bills just because they're scammers? Also, if you like this video, go ahead and hit that like button. If you haven't subscribed already, go ahead and do that. Until next time, see you then. Bye.